knows I keep talking about.
Paparazzi.
Especially when they've got a chance to do their thing. So what are we talking about? What's happening this year?
Okay, this year we're planning to make it even more exciting. We're sticking with the theme, reflecting creativity, projecting diversity. However, there is a sub-theme called rainbow, which gives it a broader
scope. You're going to paint on a body design.
You're going to do your design, your character design, or your body art design based on the theme.
You mean where we're going on?
Yeah.
Guys will find that there are a lot of individuals who want to
so much of computerization, you don't need any mind.
That's what I said to her.
Welcome.
I know you have your camera, but let me give you a hand.
Yes.
Hello,
and
welcome.
Eric, what time are you going to be here?
He's going back for a
Okay.
Oh,
Okay.
We arranged two cars.
Oh,
the
one is coming
here
now.
Wonderful.
Sure, you ready?
It's too wide?
No, you could come. That's fine. I get you. Ready? Awesome. Let me get a close up. A beautiful picture. You ready?
It's too wide?
No, you could come. That's fine. I get you. Ready? Awesome. Let me get a close up.
So we're heading to the primary school. This is, I guess, this is a regular flight out in the morning.
They come in once a day.
Once a day.
This flight is coming for some water. We just come on open
and there's a computer room
that's where we come in.
Right.
Okay. We're the PTA for the secondary.
As much as
I'm the chairperson for the school.
Okay.
So we
as much as we can see and as much as you think you need help with, that's what we need. Okay. So if we can
help us. We're working really, really hard.
And you were in the picture.
We installed a PC unit in the school.
Okay.
But there are a lot of other things that, you know, still need to be done.
Yeah, there are nine.
And a lot, she's going to be doing a lot today, and a lot of people who want to help, but not
enough.
A lot of hard owners.
I didn't know, there's any passengers over there?
No.
Different plane is coming.
Yes. I guess they do a walk, you know?
I guess it's in the loop there or
something.
I guess these two cars are for us.
I leave on Tuesday, so that's why this trip is
so rushed. These gatherings speed up. It takes off for the short run.
And stall the aircraft.
Yeah, look how quick it gets up. From 40 minutes the book, the plane.
Oh, you mentioned going to pick up people in Argentina.
Yeah.
Then go back home.
You know what I had wanted to bring the gift of light with me?
Okay, sure.
Eric Phillips.
Hi, pleasure meeting you.
How are you?
His daughter.
Very nice to meet you, Tanya.
Supriya Singh.
And we have Nadia Smith here.
Nadia.
Before we go, if I could just get a little bit, because the they're going to be in the video that we're doing today. I hope you all don't mind being videoed. But our foundation is raising a considerable amount of resources to try to help you. And a lot of donors want to be able to see and to meet you on camera. They can't be here with us today, so there are a lot of other people who are involved. So. If you could perhaps, Kim, just take a chance to introduce each person so that, you know, you can say your name.
Let me get the shots and the shakes.
Your name and what you do.
Yeah, let me get the shots and the shakes.
We'll start here, Kim. Your name?
My name is Yvonne Lear. I'm the treasurer for the secondary center. It was a secondary school.
Okay, great stuff.
Mm-hmm. I am Hormida Ribeiro. Head teacher, Santa Rosa Primary.
I'm Juanita Phillips, the chairperson for the Santa Rosa Secondary School.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Good. So, you organize this and we'll follow it.
Okay. Which car do you want to go in?
No, it doesn't matter.
Okay, well, that's just that car here is a bit.
No.
you deserve it. Let me get the next one.
Awesome.
I don't have a problem. I will drink all the water, walk at the bottom.
Supriya, can we get you in front of that sign? He had t-shirts and stuff, we can get you in front of the sign. He established 1837. Please go. 1837, come please, Miss Yvonne.
Oh, whoa! Yeah. Got it.
Oh, let the ladies all get in the picture.
Don't worry, I didn't pick it up. Now I'm gonna pick it up like that.
So the folks gotta walk through the swamps
to get here.
Mm-hmm. They probably leave their boats at a different
different landing.
That thing was made in the 70s.
Yes?
That thing.
Some of the members here who are from Moruca, Mrs. Priya Singh, she's Guyanese, but she lives in the Cayman Islands. Mrs. Stanley Ming, motorbikes, motorboat fame, all the engines around here probably came from the Yamaha. I'm Eric Phillips. This is my daughter from Canada, who's going to help do some things. We have Nadia Smith, she's a member of the group, and I'm missing our camera for Kim. I'll turn you over now to Mr. Ming to say a few words and then we'll sing.
Okay, cool. Good morning. Thank you for having me in your community. The most important thing I want to share with you is that we are here to listen to you and to see what areas that you have needs that we can possibly help. We don't promise you anything at this stage of the game because we're here to listen. And then having listened and having identified areas that we can possibly help, that's what we're here for. As you heard initially just now, I am the owner of Ming's Products and Services Limited. We are the agent for all the equipment that Yamaha makes. All the engines that you use in the boat come from us. Over the years in Guyana, I've traveled to various communities like this that are relatively remote. And in some instances, like in the case of Moruca, there was a need for children to be able to get to school from the surrounding areas that didn't have the means, the parents didn't have the means to get to them. And what I thought was a challenge in some cases is that the community gets together with the parents and the teachers, they build the boat, and I provided the engine. So if there's needs like that that we can help through the Gamma Foundation, that's what we're here to find out. If the school can, in some cases, maybe build a boat that they can be managed by the teachers and the parents, to bring kids to parents to have a board to provide a boat. Those are the kind of things we want to do. In the case of like libraries, I've outfitted many libraries around the country with books. One thing, community and the teachers and the parents work and putting together the necessary structure to be able to manage that properly. The most important thing that I want you to put in the back of your head, because I'm sure people are going to ask you in the near future when they hear that you're here. We are not here as a political group. We don't care if you voted for the AP and you the AFP or the CAP. We are here to help Guyanese. And I suspect that everybody here is a Guyanese.
So we are not interested in politics. We are interested in working with the community. Find out what your problems are and to help you in areas where we can. That's all we're here to do.
So I want that to be clearly understood. Now Mr. Singh now, who is the brain trust behind the foundation.
Good morning, everybody. Thank you for welcoming us into your community. Just the reason that we formed the Guyana Foundation is very important to you. And that is that we are absolutely tired of the fact that we've got a country that is locked with political turbulence. And from one year to the next, there's all of this political fallout that really causes the suffering among the people while politicians fight to work down. Until they fix all of these problems, the children, the country continues to suffer. And we felt that the best way that we could make a contribution at this point was to come together as a group and to seek assistance. What we were very surprised about is not only is there a great need to help from within Guyana, but there are hundreds of people overseas who would like to help Guyana. And the foundation is going to do precisely that. This video that is being taken of all of you is going to travel to California, is going to travel to the Cayman Islands, is going to travel to Greece, all over the world, who will be watching you in this video, because what they would like to do is to give back to humanity to help. We are going to do everything we can after we spend this day here with you to assess what your needs are, what are the most urgent needs you have, and we are going to go back now to try to see if you can deliver. We chose Santa Rosa because it's an area that's remote and far, and we felt that it would be a really good area to start off with because it's hard for you to even get to where the city is. You're kind of a little bit squashed out. So thank you again, and I hope that today is productive, and I hope that God blesses our mission, and that we work together to help you.
Thanks again. We have half an hour with you because we're going to go visit some other places. So whatever needs you have, please share with us. We'd like to thank the head teacher and the parents and the association for all the
thank you.
So there are no computers in here, no power. Probably we need a solar power system that gives more than just gets to like.
Sure.
Yeah.
Figure
it
out. The ceiling especially.
Yeah.
And the condition of the ceiling.
And the windows are broken open. We'll have to get some of the come in and do it.
And you have to do that in English.
I know a little, I have a little knowledge, very little knowledge of computers. I know I would like to share, but then, you know, the default of my foreign and so on. We can't do that.
Would you like someone to come and if you have the facility to do that, if you have the opportunity, mm-hmm. If you had the opportunity to do that, would you do that after hours here at your school? So in the evening after 6 o'clock when you're gone? So you might get more from 6 to 8 if you had the opportunity.
But you wouldn't be able to get internet up here. They can't get it.
Yes, you can.
A router, and it becomes like...
A wireless, router. Yeah.
He has internet access.
That's for the tour.
Exactly.
And a router is 10,000 dollars.
So, what I was saying to her is, wouldn't it be interesting if we did the gift of light for this community, which we will do once we determine this quantity of light kits we need to bring, or so that we do some kind of computer training for the people. But if that team is coming down, we could put one more person who can even sit down and do some basic computer training for the teacher as well. Okay, and then in addition to the gift of light, this community is going to be slightly different from what we've put in our home, so we really need to hear from you what you think some of the urgent needs are. But if you would like to, he mentioned fixing the well.
Yeah, but I would bring that priority, the water, because this year and I felt really lost here. Then the day they would promise you would ask them to bring you clean water, because I think the well water is in town. One time, I think it was BWI came to test for the water and they said it's good. But then there is a hole, and then sometimes we would have complaints that, you know, persons are urinating inside and so on. So I definitely it's not good.
We need a filtration system. And how many students so we can size it?
500 and 95. We had the 595 together.
$595
total. No, how long ago was that relative?
A year, like around about 6 years.
And the web itself is working. The web itself is working. The pump is working.
No, it's not working. Once a guy came to fix it from the region, and it worked just for some time, and then it stopped. Mm-hmm.
And why is it not working now? What's
something
the problem?
Something with the windmill up.
The windmill itself. And then you need sanitation.
Sanitation with the toilets. Yeah. Terrible.
How many toilets have you got?
Eight? 16. And we have a block here completely out of water.
Okay.
And this block has eight toilets.
How do portaloons work? They work, they have to be emptied. Mm-hmm. They wouldn't have that technology. You'd have to just build a new. And are they sort of, how are they? Are they flushing toilets or are they
flushing
their
toilets.
Own flushing toilets?
Flushing
toilets.
But it's here because of the water.
There's no water.
Yeah, there's
no water. So
yeah.
Right. The children know it's flushing toilets, so they will go and yank the thing.
Right.
Sorry, people
water.
Thank you.
Okay, good.
So they're all out of order.
Okay.
We just have some pictures. We have two here, right?
We have two
here. The rest of them are one laptop for families in this area.
So I think that the light and the sanitation seems to be, the light, the sanitation, and the water seems to be your most urgent needs in this area.
And their footwear, I can notice some of them.
A lot of always children are friends.
So
they
mean
that secondary is more fighting.
Do you have any idea what size ranges they go from? What sizes, like from
the
school,
right?
Yeah,
what age group?
From 5 to 11.
No, it's not really a list we need because we could just fill a 12-foot container full of food. The thing is, all I need to know is the ranges in size. Like, say, if it's not a 5-year-old, you'll probably end up... I don't know what the sizes are. They probably don't know what the sizes are.
The teachers may know what the sizes are.
Or if we buy shoes.
From what happened? Size 36. How many in the nursery? That's a separate part of the school. Okay, so we have to go and take a picture of the nursery. That's the framework.
And how many are in the secondary? 700, 800.
So 595 in the primary.
And the nursery will find out just not the same compound.
The nursery and the secondary. And the secondary you're saying how much?
795. How many teachers over there? 30-something teachers. There's 23 here in the primary. And 33 in the secondary.
So the police supervise or assess
for
the kids who are in grade 1. What about the other children? Are they coming to school
with the meal? How do they get
love? Yes, actually there's a big question here at PFPSTI was financing hot meals in grade 2 to grade 6. But it came to the end of December. We had some savings from that, so we, up to next week, Friday, we need to be able to cook for our children. After that, we don't have, the government has promised that the program will continue, but there is nothing to the hospital or bank.
And you cook locally?
Yes, we have our kitchen.
You have the kitchen out there, and all the materials come from around here.
Yes.
So the children usually would all go there?
Yeah, they're home with meals from...
All right, so...
What was the cost of this per day? The DSPR, how much is the cost of this?
It's $175 per child.
$175?
$80.
It's like $80.
Okay, well, today is the 4th. So by the 2nd, of February, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. We could get some funding to you to continue the feeding program.
just second of February, how we would have to get that money to you.
And give us an idea of the menu.
You know, like if you would like us to, it would be easy if you buy rations here, obviously, and not have to us track it, and we have to choose what to do and all of that. So what we could do is that we could pick up from the 2nd of February onwards with regard to food stuff and so on. So if you give us a rough budget
per month
of what you need, that might be useful, because then we could probably give you a few months.
Yes, we have a management committee for
food.
We have a meeting this afternoon, so it's at least I hear we
can. Okay, can we give you a telephone number that you could call?
Maybe 90-1835. Is it an officious meal? What is this?
Yes,
okay.
So if you let Mr. What is it, Eric? Just know, even if I
put it in the average,
who do they get on average? Who would they eat today?
Prepare for them.
It would normally be like the first normal meal that we would prepare at home. That's for chicken
and a little rice,
and
some vegetables
with meat. Well, every day
we
eat
meat.
Okay.
And what do they drink? They bring their own water, right?
Yeah, they bring their own water. Sometimes the kitchen will provide when we have good water.
Okay, could you
because of the water problem, we are not prepared with anything.
Could you do us a favor when you meet with your committee this afternoon, and in that amount that you're talking about, when you're working out your monthly budget, could you add in the to prepare a last note or a great part of that? If you could add that into the food box, right? And let Mr. Phillips know what it is. And then he can arrange to have the funding sent directly to you or your head of your
company.
Okay, great.
Which bank
is
it? The Republic Bank of
America. You need a keeper.
Yes, but then I'm wondering, this account is with PFDS.
Can we
open
a separate
account?
It needs
to open a Guyana
Foundation.
I mean, it could be an account once you know that's your Guyana Foundation account. Because in the event that our donors want to see what's
OTP
the
OTP has an bank account.
We'll do a separate Guyana Foundation, Santa Mission
account. Santa Rosa.
Santa Rosa.
But as a matter of urgency, though, let's stop the feeding program and the water drink for day. So what we'll do, Eric, is we'll have funding ready on the 2nd of February, which could come in to the account here.
Yes.
And we just
who's in Georgetown normally for you? Anybody? I know Sharon goes up and down. We'll organize the logistics.
So in terms of if we as the Guyana Foundation look at the gift of life for you, bringing an expert in to understand what's going on with your well and try to get it operational, getting the water systems and the toilets and so on sorted out, and getting some footwear for the children, would you consider that a big help?
Very good help.
Yeah? Okay.
How do teachers get trained? How often?
They would normally also answer for like for the training, but not all the teachers, they would normally train like the students,
mm-hmm.
and then they would come back and then have staff development sessions.
And literacy is a real problem. What about your books? Do you have enough books in the library?
Eric, you know what I think we could do is let us work on this first phase and let us, because we'll give her some time to think.
Yeah.
I mean, we just kind of come on her like that.
Yeah.
So what I think we could do is let us work on these things.
Why
I'd like to see them, and I'd like to see the
college.
If possible, before we
then
see
the
nurse. And if we could do that, and then
and
even when we need them, we work through some of the other needs, like
and just give us a better description of the school, when it was existed, who
This is to prepare like a little document for the Guyana Foundation.
Host performance, how do they perform?
Performance is not
the issue. Yeah, I know the literacy issue.
Literacy is really a problem. Yeah,
you have a special speaker.
At least one is in
the Yeah, just reason.
Yeah. So essentially, we need you to create a wish list. And let's see what we could do with a wish list.
I know one other project we can see here. If you look behind, you just have a little bed and
you get sick.
You might have children feeling unwell.
With the water and the food.
Right, unwell, and then you just can't.
When it's raining, what happens to them? They come in with a boat when it's raining.
They just get wet.
So you need, they get cold, flu. Can we see the water block? And the sanitation block. What size did you have?
Okay, good. Now, apart from that, any other urgent needs that you have to
deal? Stationery come in from Espion, spot papers.
Do your children eat at the primary school?
Yeah, they don't eat. Where do they eat? They eat in the school. They have their fast food game program.
So that one works.
Yes.
And
yes. So the school feeding program, they send buns to the school?
No, they get
food
and biscuits. The ministry provides for them.
And that's all they get?
Yeah, that's all they get.
Water?
So we have the same problem as water. We have to depend on the primary school.
So if we fix the well there, you could get water from there, yeah. But their parents have lived with them purchasing biscuits and juice?
No, some of them don't have.
Right, so if you have to feed the children, you don't have the facilities, or can you use the facilities of the primary school to feed your children? Yeah.
They
have
to do that.
Okay. So actually, yes. Prepare a better meal for your children.
Yes.
Okay. It's just that they don't have a building of their own to do that. You don't have, this is your school building, so.
Let's think about it, but we know it's 130. How many teachers?
9 of us.
9 teachers.
This one's a
bad.
It's
very
bad. It's leaking?
Yes, it's dry rot.
Yes, dry rot. Look, you're seeing it there.
Yeah.
So the dry rot and more, right? So you just set the budget. They promised
you. How long ago?
Every year. It's not in budget, though.
Okay. We are...
You have any music system?
We don't have any.
Yeah, they need a little
player
or something like that.
A little computer. Yeah. Okay. What about iPads? iPads are great for little children. You know, my baby can read and baby Einstein. These are programs, right, that go on to the computer. And basically what it does is a computer program that teaches them. It's called that, baby Einstein. My baby can read. And all the programs they can do, and they learn the alphabet, they learn the
right.
Write. So if you can get donations and things like that, you would be interested in that. Yeah.
So your name is?
Shirley Mayer.
Will you take the freezer's worker? Is it good? Is it worth it? You don't know.
Or do you think it will be fixable if, you know,
how long has it been down?
3 years.
It will have it. Okay.
We don't have the...
They don't have any sports equipment either.
No.
No balls.
No. Go ahead. Say your name.
We just bring them in for check-in. They're going to the secondary school on.
We represent the Guyana. We are the founder members of the Guyana Foundation. It is not a political organization. It's a more of a non-profit organization. We are working along with other foundations around the world, trying to help communities like this with basic needs.
Yeah.
And we, as Guyanese, feel that there has been enough politics that bogs people down, and it's either in these communities you're with one party or the other party, or you don't get help or you get help, and we're of the view that people can't wait for the right party to be in power and the right set of circumstances to be in place. So what we would like to be able to do with the Guyana Foundation is to come in, assess the needs of the community, and try to see how best we can help. We have something called the Gift of Light, which is a solar powered light kit that is portable, that each individual home can have. We looked at the school, we talked to the headmistress of the school a few minutes ago, and we looked at the water situation, the sanitation situation, and all of these things. And we're just trying to really, today, assess clearly what has to get done in this city. We've chosen Santa Rosa because we feel that, you know, you're quite remote, and it's, you know, from the town, and a little forgotten, I'm sure, on everybody's list. So,
we belong to one.
Right.
You know, anything, anytime. You can come from Kevin, you can have your groceries and now you can
it's so expensive. We figured that this would be a place to start because it's just
we know Sharon too.
It's expensive.
So we know Sharon, that we can trust her because that's we have to build mutual trust because the resources will be significant.
Sharon is the one who put them onto us here.
Yes. And Mr. Ming is with us. I don't know.
Shannon, you should know Shannon. Here he is. You resemble, you know?
Yeah, you guys probably. Wow, Ming and Ming. Oh, Ming Lanza.
Any relation to Compton?
No, no.
You don't doubt him. No, no, Compton and they go like
I think you're related to you, no.
I don't know.
Brought a couple of my calendars. I'm the person bringing Yamaha.
So you can complain now the service is bad.
Marali is my agent here.
If you need power to call family, maybe he could give his card.
So
Marali gets all this stuff on
Yeah, it's all
so
here.
It's
this is Tanya from Canada. Tanya Archer.
Hello, Karen.
This is Nadia Smith. She's from Ghana, but she's in the Bahamas.
Nice to meet you.
Are we missing one?
Kim.
Oh, Kim.
Yeah.
He disappeared from all the public relations.
The place is going to trust in an hour, so we want to talk about it to the veterinarian.
Before you go, we have a
difficult
thing.
So we're taking a picture of you signing the visit.
Yes.
Half of the guy. The 13 name.
Maybe what you could do is investigate the crowd situation. So there is this
But the thing is, I need to see not only the hammer. You want to see like other things.
She has nice accessories and so on, earrings and necklaces and fans.
Awesome. Can you walk to her place?
Yes.
Look up, Kim.
Is there a high school cricket tournament or football tournament here? The three high schools?
Yeah, I'd love
three primary schools.
So we have a picture with
you, sir.
Look at
me,
letter.
Oh, by the way, Mr. Patrick Mendoza was the former chairperson for the San Bruno Secondary School, and I took him.
Okay.
So he's well known, and he's always in community.
Yeah.
School. He always helps out.
All right, let's get a picture with him.
Just look up for me now. Great.
Hi, how are you?
Awesome. Thank you. Mr. Main, you're going to sign?
Myself, Nadia Segar, who's not here at the moment.
You want
No, we're fine. We have something of a political past in Guyana, but we reached a stage where we realized that we were engaged in a political situation and nothing was changing. And all of us, each one of us, resigned from the reform, the PNCR that we were attached to, mm-hmm. and we went back into our lives and into business and mm-hmm. went on with our lives. But our commitment and love to Guyana couldn't really be snuffed out.
Yes.
We could not walk away from it. And we came into the political arena because we wanted to help. And we found out that we were like trapped and couldn't do anything because there was so much infighting. So what we decided to do was to form the Guyana Foundation. It is not a political organization. It's a non-profit organization. We're working with organizations all over Greece, Cayman Islands, the USA, all over, different foundations,
Canada,
people who are willing and who are doing charitable work in Africa and all over the world. So what we're trying to do is to bring them and bring attention to them of different areas of Guyana.
Mm-hmm.
And to try to get we have our work stage, so stage one, stage two, we're giving away something called the Gift of Light,
mm-hmm.
which is a solar panel kit. It comes like in a little briefcase, and it can be given to an individual. A family has three bulbs in it that are specially designed with a solar panel, and that entire household could get light. And that kit lasts 12 years, or has a shelf life of 12 years. So it can significantly change people's lives because you have light
mm-hmm.
in this one little kit. So the foundation is going to be distributing these lights. And we've chosen San Bruno because we feel that you're a bit remote and the cost for you to get to where you need to go is difficult. And also because of the fact that you're a bit remote, you're a little bit on the priority list somewhere down at the bottom. So you keep looking at the bottom one side. So we just felt that this might be a good thing for us.
And Sharon is our good friend, Sharon Atkinson.
Apart from the gift of our
a few days ago, I was kind of informal, I didn't take advantage of it.
Yeah.
A lot of
promises.
As many times as you today, what is the career that can be a full formal as you can say?
Right.
There's so many questions being asked to me sometimes, you know, I'm so like, concentrated.
Yeah.
We have a brochure which we'll get to.
Yeah.
But for me, where my people can get help.
Yeah.
To show, I don't think in any way to talk about it.
Right.
I'm here to support people. I'm here to interact. I feel all political parties are important. So I won't take any type. I may have a political
preference,
but that is important.
Yep.
Yes. But in terms of where help, I think when I campaigned to become to show, I said I would try my best. Is the life of my people to be improved.
Okay.
And that doesn't have any, you know, big financial resource.
Mm-hmm.
So most likely we'll be happy to have the input to the especially if it's more like
non-governmental. Yeah.
And I recommend to start. We will be very interested to know more about
Mr. Ming and Mr. Phillips are here based in Guyana, and I will be coming in from time to time. You will get a copy of the brochure about the foundation. In Europe this morning, we started off by doing an assessment of the primary school and the nursery school, and we're going to the secondary school, hopefully, and we've been invited to take over the hospital.
Yes.
Some of the things we were talking about there were the sanitation blocks, the remote system,
mm-hmm.
the fact that the
school
supplies. Looking after the school for the children to be continued,
mm-hmm.
footwear for the children going to school, and a number of things that we did most on.
The roof of the nursery is gone.
Mm-hmm.
So this
Well, Priya and I grew up in Maipuna. Priya and I was charming, so I'll talk to her.
You know what it is.
Yeah.
As much as, you know, we are happy to have you.
Right.
Nobody
must. I'll go meet with her and take a look.
What is very important, if I can interject here, is that as Ms. Singh told you, we are not interested in the politics of what's going on. What we're most interested in is working with the community that we identify.
But you know, the politics is more interested in us.
But having said that, what I want to find out is you. I don't care who you voted for or which political party you support. But you rightly find out you're very concerned about the people you're looking at. We want to work with you, your teachers, your parents, and to be guided by you as to what your needs are and how we can help.
Yes.
So we have to come here, just, you know, put up a light here, dig a hole there. We come out, we do want to, right?
But
we will work through you to get the thing done.
Okay, I see your position though, because the questions will come to him.
Yeah,
so
that's for sure.
101.
Yeah.
So maybe what you could do, Eric, is let the minister know that we selected some
of your friends.
So
that
side they know
what
we're doing.
As soon as you get a brochure to it, they'll tell you to make it more.
Apparently, with the secondary school, they said that it was the primary school, they had an allowance for food stuff, which comes to an end very shortly, and no more. So we are going to, as of next week, we will start and spend funds for, we've asked the headmistress for a budget, for a monthly budget for the food stuff.
And so open a separate account
because
this afternoon we'll get that from her.
So as soon as next week we will be able to send money down for them to go buy it for the next couple of months.
I think
that comes to NSSRI
too, and
it's very
timely
that
he will be
here. So he needs to, he will be able to.
Well, Sharon and I are good friends. We are on a couple of boards.
Okay.
So I know Sharon 10 years.
Yeah.
As a matter of fact, she was the one that posted me when I came a month ago just to look at the community.
We just wanted you to know what we're doing. So we'd like to start that as of next week. And then from there we will be able to assess the well and the water discussion.
I know you are worried about making promises.
We're
going
to start.
I know you're not.
The most urgent thing I think we need to fix right now is to get the food stuff for that feeding program.
And then we're looking at the water system and the sanitation block.
Yeah.
And you know, we need some sanitation, especially when you have a very good
shade.
Maybe not in my mind.
How many people? About 17,000, 15,000?
Around that area.
Okay,
so you get the largest village?
Population.
And so it definitely will be the most difficult village in terms of administration. And so actually one of my plans when I came into this office here was to actually see how I can be able to improve the speed of data, you know, in terms of population, in terms of
All right, let's get
They can get an internet connection from here. Yeah, digital in
a Rosa.
The one thing I wanted to ask you, Michelle, with all this, we are trying the best that we can try to bring some relief to this village and to Guyana as a whole. We would like to sort of ask you to work along with us. We'll get the clearance that we need in order to do it properly.
Yeah.
But let us see if we could express when we start to do these projects. I don't want to think that after all that we try to do to bring assistance, that things are just like left dormant and computers are thrown about and you know, like there's no appreciation. So if it's possible to like let us build a community so that even with the teachers, if we do the sanitation block, then the teachers should help to keep it, make the children keep it clean and this and that. Why I say that, right, is because I'm dealing with some donors who are helping in Africa to the tune of millions of US dollars. And I'm talking to them every day. And one of the things they say to me when I talk to them, they say, you know, Supreme, we will come and help you with Guyana. Let's try Guyana. Because what happens in Africa is that the people who we talk to get our money and our donations, they take it. And then when we go to visit the community, everything is just like
Radar, you know, radar.
So I want to be able to say to even any of our donors, jump in a plane with me, come to Santa Rosa, meet the Tushar, go to the village, see what it is we've done, and they can see for themselves.
And, they'll give more.
That this is a community that is not just like
waiting for handouts. They are.
You know, it's a community that wants
self-help. Yes.
If you look around and look. As you see here, you can see a community in progress. One of my visions is another thing that we are really important to do that. We can maintain our culture.
Yep.
But we've been too far back. We've back to our heading comfort. Our people need development to have really good culture.
Okay.
We do get some book foundation, but then, you know, it only gets the reference for
the system. How did I hear
that? We don't break that. We have a room that we put aside, right at the back there.
That could be turned into a library.
Right, we want.
And you basically want books in all
the capacities. Okay. Things like internet, we do have the internet on here.
Right,
so the encyclopedia could still be, you know, a useful piece of document to research from.
Okay.
Encyclopedias, dictionaries, information technology, and in all public areas, if you just go in there, you have references for your assignments. And also, we're thinking about.
So, one of the outside would be the boys.
Yeah. So, thank you. I guess when it gets dark, everybody.
Do they get electricity at night?
Yeah.
Yeah, from 6 to 9, right?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, 6.
This is our last stop, baby.
Yeah, and then we go to the hospital near the airport. Supriya, this is much deeper than land. That's nice.
Right here, so we don't have
to take a picture. Yeah, okay.
Right here?
That's where she is?
Yeah, that's how.
Okay.
That's where she is, isn't it?
Yeah.
That's where she wants to set up her little office.
Right
here.
Does that fall on the
earth?
Have you?
Dorms?
Yes. You have to.
Yes.
And the ministry helps you.
This is
where
cute.
Do they eat? How do they eat?
We are in the dorm. Kim?
This is dorm. There's a female dorm.
And
the male. Oh, that's a male dorm.
And the government supplies the food for the people who live in. Okay.
And how far do they come from?
Oh. 20 to 40 miles away.
Oh my goodness.
So they can
hear it. By water.
Any necessary help to get the dorms back up and running properly? And
the windows.
Well, yes.
Look at the windows.
Towels.
Look at the windows.
That would be good, yes.
Towels.
Where's the sanitation block
for
this?
It's indoors.
Yeah, we saw them on matrasses. They were
really bad.
In fact, I sent a requisition like ages ago to our defense matrasses. We really need them. Mm-hmm. The data has not been.
And that's about a year ago, right? Or something.
And you just need single one.
Well, we have double, most of them are double.
Double.
When it rains, it, I guess.
Yes.
How long have those windows been missing and broken?
I came here I took over the school in September, and it was broken, so I guess my kids.
Is it my
Nice to meet you.
Smith and Ms. Chung.
Hello.
And Mr. Ming is Stanley Ming.
I am Supriya Singh.
Yeah, he's looking at
nice.
Say? Yeah, we have Hi. We only have about 10 minutes because the plane is on the ground. But when I spoke with Ms. Atkinson, she said that there's a need here when there are emergencies, there's no transportation or something.
Yeah, for yeah. We just want to give you a brief thing because we've been through the village all morning for the primary school, the secondary school, the nursery school. The Guyana Foundation is an organization set up primarily by myself, Eric, and Mr. Ming, who I think you all know. We're working with donors internationally as well. It's not a political organization. It's a non-profit organization that brings relief where it's needed. We're handing out something called the Gift of Light, which is a solar power kit that provides electricity to buildings and so on. And it's almost like in a briefcase form.
Okay.
So we bring it into the communities and give that out where it's needed. We also do other types of projects. So we chose Santa Rosa as a place that we could do our pilot project in Guyana. And we've been able this morning to visit the primary school, the nursery school, the secondary school, and now you. And basically the same question we put to everybody is, in your operating, kind of daily operating of this facility, what are the things that are holding you back the most? What is it that you need help with the most?
As you rightly said, right now we really need a boat convention. Right now, because the primary means of sanitation. Because we're a district hospital and there are only certain things we could do right here. So we have to transfer patients out there.
Okay. And so you have no boat, no engine?
Right now, no.
So if somebody got sick and had to get to Sunny
right
Day,
we have
to
hire.
We have to hire.
Yeah.
And
of course,
we'll
have to wait on the money.
We still hire them. Sometimes we have to wait for them to fuel up and things. Because, I mean, our boat captain is very close. So, I mean, if we have our own boat in India, we take them out very fast. Mm-hmm.
What size of boat are you looking at? And the boats are available.
I am not
to
an expert on the size of
the boat. The size we had, which was comfortable, is... I think it's 18 by 4.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
The captain will be able to give.
Yeah.
It's
right.
They're made in the Moruca
River.
Because many times we have more than one patient.
Yeah, I'll go over here.
But
you have tanks.
How you get water?
We have tanks. We have to pump from the creek.
Pump from the creek, but you got filtered. That you do filter the water from the creek.
Do you have a constant supply of water though?
When there's rain.
Which is two seasons.
Come is here. This is our two boat captains.
I think I've seen before Ghana goes.
Oh.